victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And let us talk about the name of Allah Azza wa Jal, An-Nasir. Let us talk about the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, An-Nasir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us guidance and assist us to talk about this beautiful name of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the name of Allah Azza wa Jal, An-Nasir. And there is some chatting going on. It's okay. So the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, An-Nasir, is the name which we are talking about today. What do you know about the name of Allah, An-Nasir? Think about it. What do you know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, An-Nasir? The stories of Allah's victory. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliated His enemies, though they were the strongest at the time. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the believers, though they were the weakest, maybe. They were weak, and they had nothing, they had no power. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored them. How Bilal radiallahu anhu was being tortured in the desert of Mecca. Then he became Sayyidina Bilal, and he started fighting against the pagans who used to own him a few days ago. And he started, talking against them. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors the believers, because one of his names is An-Nasir. And before talking about this name, let us go to the main word which this name comes from. Victory in Arabic is An-Nasr. An-Nasr is victory in Arabic. Tamam? Now, the one who gives victory in Arabic is Nasir. And this is the name of our principal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect him. So Nasir, the one who gives victory. Yes? طيب. What about An-Nasir? What is the meaning of An-Nasir? What is the difference of An-Nasir and Nasir? An-Nasir, my brothers and sisters, is a form and a structure of Nasir with more exaggeration. So Nasir, I can be Nasir and you can be Nasir. You give victory to your son, for example. You give victory to that person when they have disputes or they have problems. But An-Nasir, there is more exaggeration, meaning Allah is An-Nasir. No matter how strong your enemy is, and no matter how many they are. So in number and power, regardless, Allah will give you Nasr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give victory. So Nasr in Arabic is victory. Nasr is the one who gives victory. And Nasir is an exaggeration of Nasr. Meaning, giving that meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give you victory regardless of your situation and regardless of how strong your enemy is. The structure of exaggeration, Nasir. And is Nasir also a name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The scholars have two opinions. And it's better to be very careful with the names of Allah Azza wa Jal, because we said at the start of this lectures, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and you, we said that the names of Allah Azza wa Jal are tawqifi, meaning only to be taken from the Quran and Sunnah. And the Quran was very clear in mentioning that Allah Azza wa Jal is An-Nasir. However, the name An-Nasir was mentioned more like an attribute of Allah. More like an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's better to be careful. An-Nasir is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, it was mentioned in the Quran, and mainly in two verses, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وكفى بربك نصيرا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وكفى بربك هاديا ونصيرا. Meaning, وكفى. كفى meaning Allah is enough. Allah is sufficient for you to bring victory, to give you victory, to make you victorious. وَكَفَى. Allah is kafi. Allah is sufficient for you to bring victory. And this is very beautiful meaning in these verses. But the victory itself was mentioned in the Quran in several verses. as the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was also involved in battles and fighting and facing the pagans and the enemies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلَيَنصُرَنَّ اللَّهُ مَن يَنصُرَهُ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّا لَنَنصُرُ رُسُلَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَن نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ So, النصر, victory. And I want to ask you a question. I want to ask my dear brothers and sisters a question. What is your perspective of victory? يعني when I tell you victory, what do you think about it? Let us contemplate, let us think. What is the perspective of victory in our minds? Is victory only to defeat the enemies physically and take over the lands and have stronger armies and stronger tanks and rockets and bombs? Is this victory? Is this the real victory when you take over, when no one can harm you and you can harm anyone? Is this victory? It might be, yes. It might be a type of victory. We're not denying it. However, Islam teaches us that victory is not only the physical one, which is on the ground. Your steadfastness is also victory. When the whole world are against you to change your belief and you hold on to it, this is also victory. So victory is not only when your army defeats the other army and when you take over the lands and you... Victory can also mean when you hold on to your religion, no matter what happens. And this is from the story of Musa. Unfortunately, many of us know one story of victory in the story of Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun, and they do not know the other one. There are two stories of victory in Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun and what happened between them. The first story, the one we know, the physical victory, where Allah Azza wa Jalla drowned Fir'aun and he saved Musa alayhi salam and Bani Israel. The other story of victory is the story of the woman which was working for Fir'aun. And I'm sure you started remembering that story. The daughter of Fir'aun's daughter, she used to have that hairdresser. She would work for her. And one day, something falls down, falls down on the floor. So the hairdresser, she tries to take that object from the floor, and she said, Ya Allah, she was a believer. And at that time, everyone used to believe that Fir'aun is the god, and they were worshipping Fir'aun. So she said, Ya Allah, and Fir'aun's daughter, she told her, What are you saying? Are you referring to my dad, or you have other god? So the hairdresser told her, Allah is my Lord, and the Lord of your father. Allah is my creator and the creator of your father. She had the chance to take it by the permission of Allah and hide her belief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't hold her accountable. But she chose her way to show her belief and her iman. Because if everyone takes by the permission, Islam will perish. So some people will show steadfastness against the tyrants and the kuffar. So the hairdresser of Fir'aun's daughter, she said, Allah is my Lord and the Lord of Fir'aun and the Lord of your father. So the daughter, she went and she informed her father. And Fir'aun, he ordered to prepare a big pot of boiling oil. Oil boiling. And the long story, let us cut it short. He brought that woman with her five kids, and he asked her to repent and declare that there is no God except Fir'aun. She refused, and he started throwing her five kids one by one, and he threw her as well in that boiling oil. Now, it might seem to the people at that time that she lost her life. Who is the victorious in their eyes? Fir'aun, with his power, with his strength. But in reality, who is the real victorious? The woman. The woman, the hairdresser of Fir'aun's daughter, who stayed steadfast on her religion and her belief. So the first type of victory, which is very important for us to know, is steadfastness. When my sister holds on to her hijab, to her deen, to her faith, this is victory. When she teaches her children Quran and Islam, this is victory. When our brother refuses to work in haram and involve in haram, this is victory. When our children read Quran and memorize Quran, and they are being encouraged by the parents, even in this time where corruption is everywhere in the schools and homosexuality and whatnot, and these ideologies, this is victory. Steadfastness is victory. Read the story of Ashab al-Ukhdud. Read the story of Bilal radiallahu anhu ardah. Holding on to your religion, not changing your faith because of the pressure, is victory. In a time we see women taking off their hijab, men involving in haram and losing their religion, children, they losing their time and wasting their time in playing and games and haram. This is victory. You are the strong person. You are the strong mother. You are the strong son. You are the strong daughter. You are the strong father. This is victory. However, steadfastness is victory. However, we do not deny that also victory has to be on the ground, or should be on the ground physically. It should be on the ground. And this happened to the Sahaba, to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, they conquered Mecca and then Arabia, and then the Sahaba, they took over Persia and parts, big parts of the Roman Empire. They were victorious on the ground, so we do not deny that victory can exist also physically and in our eyes and on the ground and in the measurement of people, based on the measurement, strength and power and army. Yes, this also can exist. But also steadfastness and holding on to your religion, to your faith, to your belief, is also victory. So do not despair. The victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is on the ground physically, the real victory as people describe. This victory of Allah Azza wa Jal, if you read the Quran and if you read the Sunnah, it has two elements that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give us victory. And I feel that this name of Allah Azza wa Jal, Al-Nasir, the one who gives victory, it's really needed in our time. Because we discuss this topic every day without knowing or without knowing. When you hear the news, when you hear this country attack this Muslim country, and this people, this much of people were killed in this Muslim country, we start discussing this matter, the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Sahaba, they discussed it. The prophets, they asked. This happens to everyone. And I felt that especially in this time where the ummah is, you know, divided in parts and weak in general, it is much needed for us to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Nasir. This victory of Allah Azza wa Jal can be in the dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this is the evidence, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ إِنَّا لَنَنْصُرُ رُسُلَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, verily, us, يعني Allah, will give victory to our prophets and those who believed في الحياة الدنيا, in the worldly life. In this life, Allah Azza wa Jal surely would give victory to the believers. Surely Allah Azza wa Jal would reveal His religion. Surely Allah Azza wa Jal will bring an nasr and victory in this dunya. Yes, in this dunya. And the two elements of this victory are, first, belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which leads to His obedience. And the second is to prepare based on your abilities. When Umar radiallahu anhu sent the troops and the armies to fight the Persians in an area called Al-Basra in southern Iraq and Al-Ahwaz, in that area, he sent the army to fight the Persians. And he told them that the number of the army doesn't scare me. I'm not scared of the number and the technology. But the thing which I scare most on you are your sins. Your sins and your mistakes. I'm scared from your sins and your mistake, which could delay victory. But I'm not scared of the number of the army. So belief and having trust in Allah Azza wa Jal is the first element of victory. Second, to prepare yourself. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَأَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ, and prepare for them whatever you can of power. And here Allah Azza wa Jal didn't ask us to be equal in power, but He asked us to prepare whatever we can based on our abilities. And this is the victory on the ground. The question is, my brothers, that we ask, why, since we are the believers and we are the Muslims and we are the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and others are disbelievers and others, why we lose some battles? Why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lost some battles? Why the Sahaba, they were defeated in some battles? Why? And we ask these questions. Why this happened to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Let us go through the battles which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Muslims were defeated in. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Muslims were defeated in two main battles, as you know. One of them, the Battle of Uhud, and one of them, the Battle of Hunain. And let us take the lessons and the reason, and let us take the lessons from these two battles. So the Battle of Uhud was in the third Hijriya, so 3 years after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's migration. And the Battle of Hunain was in the 8th Hijriya. And these two battles, as we said, the Muslims were defeated in them. Why they were defeated? Let us start with the Battle of Uhud in the 3rd Hijriya. In the Battle of Uhud, the Prophet ﷺ asked some archers to stay on the mountain and never leave your position, whatever happens. No matter what happens, don't leave your position. Don't leave the location on top of the mountain. Close to the end of the battle, the Muslims were about to win the battle. The archers, they thought that the battle was finished. And they forgot that the Prophet ﷺ told them, do not leave your position. And some of them, they wanted to take the ghanaim and the swords and what the pagans left on the ground. So they left the mountain, basically. And they disobeyed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They left their positions. So the army of the pagans, leading by Khalid ibn al-Walid radiallahu anhu arda, before he becomes a Muslim, they went around the mountain and they could come very close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they harmed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they threw rocks at him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So why they were defeated in this battle, the Battle of Uhud? The reason? Disobedience. There was a problem in the actions. They believe in Allah, they believe in the Prophet, but they disobeyed. They disobeyed. Error in the action. The second battle was the battle of Hunayn. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنَ إِذْ أَعْجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ. And on the day of Hunayn, where you were happy and satisfied with the big number that you had. The Muslims, this is, by the way, the only, they say that this is the only battle where the Muslims were more in number than the pagans, than the enemies. So in every battle, the Muslims are less and they win. In this battle, the Muslims were more in number, and they were fighting against two tribes from Arabia. And what some of the Sahaba said, and remember this and listen to this, they said, لَن نُغْلَبَ مِنْ كَثْرَ. That a small number wouldn't defeat us. We are more in number, we will surely win and defeat our enemies. So they were satisfied and enjoyed with the, they were satisfied and happy with the numbers they had. So they were defeated in this battle. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the reason why, that they liked the number and they thought with the number they will win. So there was an error, not in the actions, the physical actions, but the error was in the belief and the actions of the heart. So basically these two battles, yani subhanallah, probably Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to take these lessons. Allah azza wa jal could give victory to his prophet, but even with the loss of the prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there are lessons for the ummah until the day of judgment. And these lessons are, to summarize, that the loss is either because an error in our actions or an error in the belief. Some of us, we believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. We believe Allah Azza wa Jal will give us victory. But in some cases, we disobey. And this is what Umar said to his army, that I'm not scared that your enemies are hundreds or thousands or millions, but I'm scared that you would commit sins and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't give us victory. But at the end of the day, my brothers and sisters, with all these categories and the reasons of failure, the reasons of being defeated, the reasons for our losses, with all of this, at the end of the day, we are the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Yani the question is there any other ummah, nation in the world which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give victory to because of the belief, because of the obedience? Because yani we are the ummah which believes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his prophet. We are the ummah which believes in the five pillars of Islam and implement them. We believe in the six pillars of Iman. We believe in our aqeedah. We teach our children Islam. We are the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And by Allah, this is the only ummah which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make victorious. But the only thing which we have to worry about is that oh Allah, do not change us, but use us. Yani don't let different generation honor Islam and we become disobedient. And you change us with a different generation and different people of Muslims. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use us and not to change us. And even because the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the special ummah of Allah azza wa jal, even in the losses that we go through, there are lessons. And I want to finish with this, with what Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said regarding the hikmah and the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala behind the rotation of the power, the rotation of power between believers and non-believers. He mentioned rahimahullah many, and I only picked two which I thought they are very important. The first one is that at the time of weakness, the hypocrite would be exposed with what's really in his heart. Why? Because hypocrites, they with you when you are strong. But when you lose your power, they will go and shift into the other side with your enemies. And the other reason is also that the believers, they will prove their true belief and iman and steadfastness. The other reason which Ibn al-Qayyim, the other wisdom of Allah Azza wa Jal, which Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned, rahimahullah, is that Allah Azza wa Jal with this, during this weakness, during these trials, during the fitan that we face, and we are facing this in the schools and our societies, and by migrating from countries to countries, we are facing these trials. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with these trials, He would elevate the believers and He will increase them in khair and goodness in what He left for them in the Jannah, in the eternal life. Because this life is short and the eternal life is waiting for us. So this is the summary. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says at the end, يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تنصروا الله ينصركم ويثبت أقدامكم. All you have believed, if you give victory to Allah, Allah will give victory to you. You might ask, how can I give victory to Allah? How can I give victory to Allah? Give victory to His religion. Give victory to His halal and haram. Give victory to His religion inside your house. Teach your children Islam and Quran. With your wife, give victory to your religion. The wife, give victory to your deen and Islam by teaching your children, by dressing well when you get outside and protecting the halal and haram of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give victory to the religion of Allah by learning the aqeedah and the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give victory to the religion of Allah by memorizing the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and learning it. Give victory to the religion of Allah, and Allah will give victory to us. And I'll finish up with this sentence of one of the scholars. He said, أَقِيمُ الْإِسْلَامَ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ يُقَامُ لَكُمْ فِي وَاقِعِكُمْ. Establish Islam in your hearts, and you will find it established in your societies. Establish Islam in your hearts, and you will find it established in your societies. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala end for us with good. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Nasir brings His victory to the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to our brothers and sisters in Syria, in Iraq, in Libya, in Palestine, in Shishan, in Kashmir, in China. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give victory to them. And the Ummah is suffering in every spot, in every place. And surely the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.